We had quite a few questions from the walkie-talkie project around ESP-NOW and what the actual range is. They're all good questions and they'll be answered in a future video. This video is a bit of prep work. I wanted to get a GPS board connected up to my ESP32 so I could test ESP-NOW out in the wild while walking around. But before cracking on, I'd like to thank PCBWay for sponsoring this video. PCBWay offer PCB production, CNC and 3D printing, PCB assembly and much, much more. They're great to deal with and offer excellent quality, service and value for money. Check out the link in the description. So I had a look in my box of old bits and bobs and I found this board. I backed the Tessel 2 on Kickstarter quite a few years ago and ended up with a whole bunch of modules. It seems to be a bit of a dead project now. Let me know in the comments if they're still going. This is an A2235-H GPS module from Lantronics. It's a nice little GPS board, and as with most GPS devices, it supports a serial connection. So wiring it up is simply a case of connecting power along with the RX and TX lines. There are a couple of interesting wrinkles with this board. The first is that it has an on-off pin to control whether it is switched on or off. This needs to be taken high to make the board wake up. The other wrinkle is that it uses a proprietary binary protocol called SiRF and needs to be instructed to switch to the standard NMEA text format. Now, you can do this with some pull-up resistors on a couple of the pins, but as these pins are not broken out on this board, I'll need to send it a special command to switch to the NMEA mode. Testing out a GPS board is pretty straightforward. Most of us will have one of these USB to UART boards lying around, so we can simply wire the GPS board up to it and use a terminal program. If you've got a standard GPS board, then it will probably be running at 9600 baud, 8 bits and no parity with one stop bit, but check the docs for your board to confirm this. With my board, it boots up in SiRF mode and you need to connect to it at 115,200 baud. As you can see, it immediately starts to output binary data. To switch it into NMEA mode, we need to send this binary command. This will switch the device to NMEA with a baud rate of 4800. Once we send this message, we can reconnect our terminal at 4800 baud and we start to see the nice NMEA ASCII messages coming through. At the moment the board's on my desk, so we aren't getting any location data. You can see this in the GGA messages that are coming through. However, after leaving it on the window for a while, we get a fix and location data starts to come in. If you're having problems with your GPS board, hooking it up directly to your computer and using a terminal program is definitely a good first step towards troubleshooting. A good sign that things are happening is the RX LED flashing, indicating that data is coming in from the board. Moving on to the ESP32, using a GPS board with an ESP32 and the Arduino framework is pretty straightforward. The ESP32 has 4 serial peripherals available, and it's also very flexible on the pins that can be used, so we can wire our GPS board up to pretty much any pins we want. You can also include indicator LEDs on the RX and TX lines to help diagnose any problems. Both the RX and TX lines are active low, so you just need to connect up a resistor and an LED to the 3.3 volt line. You should see the RX line pulsing fairly regularly as data is transmitted from the GPS. Setup and reading from serial ports is really easy with Arduino code. For my GPS board, I do have some initialization to do. I need to initially connect at 115,200 baud, and I need to toggle the on-off pin from low to high. Once I've done that, I just send the command to switch to NMEA mode and reconnect at 4800 baud. With that done, we can simply read from our serial peripheral and output the results to the default serial. Running this up, we can see that we get NMEA messages echoed from the GPS board. This is all very good, but it's not very usable. You really need to parse the messages coming in and turn them into position data. Of course, we could write our own parser, but honestly, life is way too short for that. There are lots of GPS libraries available. It's worth having a look around to find one that suits your needs. If you've got any favourites, then please leave some suggestions in the comments. I found a very nice C++ library for doing the parsing of the data that seems to work well on the ESP32 and also plays nicely with the streaming data directly from the serial peripheral. With it wired in, we now get a lot of interesting data from our GPS device. Probably a bit too much information, to be honest. For most projects, you'll generally just want the latitude and longitude along with some indication of how good the fix is. I've hooked up the GPS to my TTGO display board. and set it up to show some of the useful information coming from the GPS. I've put all the code for this up on GitHub, the link is in the description. The code should support both SiRF and NMEA based boards. There's a video coming up in the pipeline where we use this GPS to measure the effective range of ESP-NOW in the real world, so don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.